My name is Jose Salcedo, mostly known as Ray among the LAFC community. And I've been following LAFC since day one, literally day one. Tonight, por Los Angeles, vamos! It was something that we were looking for a long time. A club that really represented the community of LA, and we got it. When they made the announcement of the stadium in Los Angeles, I remember clearly me and my compadre would look at each other when Kerwin Price said, the stadium is gonna be built on the District 9 of Los Angeles. And we look at each other and I was like, that's it. We are the District 9, because we're gonna be the roots of this club. Well, you know what? It was very special when we started. We literally were block by block. You know, everybody said, this club is gonna play in 2 years? 3 years? 4 years? You're crazy, man. But we believed in this project since day one, and we didn't get tired of inviting people to come and join it. And right now, when you see it, it's everything that we dreamed of. LAFC really shows what the community is about. When you walk into the stadium of Bank of California, it's like walking to a market in downtown LA. You know, South Central, East LA, Hollywood. The people that you see in those communities is the same people that you see in the stadium. That's why it feels like home. The 3252 is something else. You know, it's funny when we were talking about coming up with the name of the supporters. You know, in the culture, you know, everybody makes fun of other groups' names, right? Me and Julio will say, dude, if we pick a name, they're gonna clown us one way or another. They're gonna look for something that is gonna make fun of us. And when the 3252 came about in one of the meetings, we look at each other and said, like, look, they cannot make fun of a number, man. You know, and plus, you know, it's so much meaning behind it that, you know, we are above and beyond a regular fan. Hey. When we talk about the casual culture, right? It's something that came from Europe. When you follow the European leagues and you get more involved with what goes behind the scenes, right? Because football is just the 90 minutes on the pitch. You know, the culture is what happens right around it. And you start learning, you know, how the casuals came about. You know, a lot of the people here, we embraced it. You know, it's a lifestyle. It's not only the way you dress, but it comes with the way you manage yourself. You know, it's music, it's community, it's sharing what you know. I got about 350 scarves that I've collected throughout the years. I've been collecting for over 16 years. Es un estilo de vida, es una pasión que te nace. Yeah! Y por ahí tengo como unas 300 jerseys. And I got a little bit over 200 pairs of Adidas, man.
What? 200 pairs of Adidas?
200 pares de Adidas. ¿Los quieres ver?
Yeah.
Va, pues, síganme los buenos. Check this out. All right, brothers, so this is the big closet. Check it out. So this is the big room. And as you can see, man, if you're not a fan, it'll be hard for you to understand. Adidas, you know, it's been around for a very long time. I remember back in Mexico when my dad bought me some Adidas. He actually took them from the US to Mexico. It was special having something from the US. You know, Adidas is nostalgia. When you have those memories when you're a young kid, and now that you're an adult and you can actually purchase one of those shoes, you get the same feeling. Getting my first pair of Adidas from Europe, it was very special. And I was just counting the days to get them on the mail, man. We always say, and we always tell the boys, hey, never put your head down in front of a man unless it's to admire his Adidas shoes. Todo lo que la marca Adidas lleva alrededor hace que sean las cosas más especiales. En nuestro caso, en la cultura casual, miras cómo la comunidad se empapa de algo que no es de nosotros, pero es algo que adoptamos. We try to give it our twist and make it LA casual culture. These shoes right here, being able to come up with something like this and being part of it, it was super special. For us to sit down and talk to the Adidas people and let them know, you know, what we like, how we are, what we dress, what we think, and present it on this, this is something very special. Los Angeles Sambas, LAFC Sambas. This sneaker, it's super special. Not only because we designed them, but because not a lot of people have them. There was only about 40 pairs of these shoes made. This represents the work. It's gold, baby. So now these ones are so special, man, that I had to get them tattooed. You know, this shoe means so much. So much hard work, so many hours of the 3252 sitting down with the people from Adidas and brainstorming one by one, block by block, shoulder to shoulder. It's super special. These are the District 9 Terrace Trainers. These ones right here are the Adidas Hamburg. When I first ordered them, and I ordered them from England, I was waiting for them for about 2 weeks and a half, you know, counting every day. And when I was able to open the box, man, it was a very special feeling that I have every time I pop one of those boxes. All right, so my favorite silhouette of all time, and the ones that get my heart pumping, Adidas Londons. You know, this silhouette here, it just speaks quality. It's the fabric of it, the way it looks, the way it feels. It's just beautiful, man. Oh, those I'll never wear them. I'm only gonna wear them when my son gets married. Oh. it's a drop and a collaboration between Adidas and CP Company. And this ones I will never wear until the North End. Here we go again with the Hamburgs. You know, it's a beautiful silhouette. These ones, I don't mind taking them to the stadium. These ones, I don't mind getting them beer showered because they're pretty easy to clean, you know? This one is just the most recent one that came out a couple of days, you know? Still smells fresh, right out of the oven. Ugh, this one, probably you can be a lawyer, a doctor. I don't know, brother. You can even become the president wearing these ones. The 3252, we wanted to take it to the next level. We wanted to be not only the best supporter group in California, but to be one of the best groups that can take the culture to another level. And I think we accomplished it with this shoe. La raza, la paisanada, como decimos, la comunidad mexicana, latina, salvadoreña que está en la zona norte. You wear your Adidas, you wear, you know, your guayabera, dude. You know, whatever makes you happy. That's LA. Y tener nuestros zapatos es algo bien especial. Cuando es día de ir partido, es algo espiritual. Todos tenemos una rutina, todos tenemos un ritual. Te preparas no nada más mentalmente, sino físicamente, y pues te vas bien hidratado al estadio. Te llevas tus líquidos favoritos para pasarla bien y convivir con toda la familia de LAFC. Y estar en las gradas, estar en la zona norte, el poder compartir con la gente nueva que llega por primera vez al Bank of California, it's magical. When they walk into the North End, it's like when a kid walks into Disneyland. So when it comes to barra brava, football culture, hooliganism, fights, we don't want it. You know, we want a sport that can be family oriented. We want a sport where family can come and cheer and participate. We want kids to come and jump and sing and bang drums. And for them to say, this is my house. You know, when we walk outside the stadium and you see people from the opposite team shaking your hand and saying, dude, you guys were loud. You guys brought it, man. Hey, congratulations. Come back to our town. That, to me, it's more than punching somebody in the face and stealing their scarf. Anybody can do that. Earning somebody else's respect in their house, not everybody can do that. With Portland, we've had a very tight connection since back in 2009. Look, I get the chills, man, just to remember that. I have one scarf that is super special to me. And that scarf, my buddy Abraham from Portland Timbers gave it to me. And that was at the first meeting that we had for the Independent Supporter Council. We said, you know what? No agenda. Let's talk about football. Let's talk about our culture. And we just started talking about the game, you know. And we got so into it that at one point, my friend Abraham just gets up. And this guy is like almost 7 foot, you know, super tall. And he tells me, hey, Ray, everything that I was thinking, you just said. And he takes off his scarf and wraps it around my neck. And that day, my priorities changed. Eso es lo que queremos traer nosotros a esta liga. Algo que queremos dejar como legado en esta liga es de que somos en contra de la violencia. Para que nuestros hijos y nuestros nietos lo puedan disfrutar, puedan venir en familia y crecer con el fútbol. Because this is our club and this is our community. This is where we're going to be for so many years to come.